Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. My respected scholars, Sadat al-Ulama, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. A few years ago, when I was blessed to take part in the wonderful annual largest gathering of people around the world, the walk of freedom, the walk of love, the walk to Abu Abdullah al-Husayn in Karbala in Arba'een, I saw a sight that was amazing. And most of us have seen wonderful occasions and moments. One thing attracted me. There was an elderly gentleman who was facing the Zuwar. So he was standing in the middle of the road and the Zuwar were walking towards him. And in his hands, he had a plate of tamur and dates. And on this dates, there was the special syrup or what's known as the shira or rashi. And he was holding it with his hands. I was observing what he was doing. And when I got close, I realized he was looking for people in order to place the date in their mouth. And so there was a brother next to me, and he approached this gentleman, this servant of Abu Abdullah, and said to him, "Please, I have had many dates. I'm not interested." The man began to cry. I saw the tears in his eyes. He said to him, "لا تحرمني من خدمة زوار الحسين." Don't deprive me from the service towards the Zuwar of Abu Abdullah. Now I wondered after this incident, and I said, "Salamullahi alayka ya Abu Abdullah, how have you captured the minds and the hearts of people for 1400 years? This love is incredible. They haven't met you, they haven't spoken to you, but it's not something that can be easily understood." And today, when we are, alhamdulillah, blessed to be serving the member of Abu Abdullah al-Husayn, it's such a true honor. Because I remember Ayatullah al-Udma Bahjat, rahmatullahi alayhi, used to say that every majlis of Abu Abdullah is an extension from the shrine of Husayn. And every attendant of a majlis is a zair of Abu Abdullah al-Husayn. And this is a special honor. Now, when we are entrusted with this honor, I want to ask one question with the 2 minutes that I have left. What is the language of Abu Abdullah? How did he become so influential? And what does it mean to us today? Last year, I was in a gathering for non-Muslim teachers who are teaching religious education to people in different schools. The gathering was at Al-Khu'i Center. And there was, of course, an individual very well known. He's not a Muslim, but he does excellent work, Dr. Chris Hewa. He was speaking to the teachers, and he said, "You know, when the Shia speak to me about Hussein, I say to them, stop. Stop telling me about the sadness of the story. Tell me how it changed your life. Tell me how influential it was to you. Sadness, I know. But I want to see the impact on you." And today, we really have to ask this question. What is the language of Abu Abdullah? I want to just mention one point, that in order for us to appreciate how Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam was effective in delivering the message, we need to speak his language. And I don't mean the Arabic or the different other verbal languages. I mean the methodology, the identification of what were the problems and the symptoms in society. He recognized there was dha'ful irada. People were not able to distinguish between haqq and batil. He shook their foundations and he changed them. Today we have to look at our society and understand that we have challenges that as speakers and scholars we have to be experts and equipped for. So what is the recommendation and the practical point that I would like to present is, today, for example, we have in schools in the United Kingdom increasing pressures on students to engage in certain activities and to be involved in certain mindsets. According to statistics, over 60% of students at UK schools feel a sense to be involved or somehow included in the sexualization of thought and action. Today we have the increase in the LGBT community and their impact on our communities and our children. Today we have many marital problems. The question that I would like to pose is, if we were to become effective muballighin in the path of Abu Abdullah and speaking the language of Hussein, we need to be trained. And I know, alhamdulillah, our scholars are trained in the Quran and in the hadith and in the delivery of the message. But what we need to do, and remembering, starting with myself, the verse that says, وَفَوْقَ كُلِّ ذِي عِلْمٍ عَلِيمٍ, remembering that we need to engage in certain training to be able to deal with these problems. I need to be able to know how mental health presents itself before myself. If somebody comes to see me, or if I'm delivering a message towards people, I need to know what makes them understand and how can I make the message reach them. I need to understand the psychology. Therefore, my recommendation is that for the ulama and the muballighin to have regular training courses on matters that are very effective in world today, contemporary issues and challenges, so that we can discuss and share ideas and exchange ways in which we have been effective in dealing with this. I give you, and I end with this story. A few days ago, a sister called me. She said, my 16-year-old girl, she's taking off a hijab. She doesn't want to wear hijab. She will only speak to someone who speaks English, alim. Can you speak to her? I said, very well. I spoke to her. She asked me a question. She said, if I take off my hijab, am I going to Jahannam? I said, Allahu A'lam. I don't know. You're committing a sin. It is a disobedience of God. But I don't decide who's going to Jahannam or not. She went and told her mother, see, I'm not going to Jahannam. The mother picked up the phone and says, how can you not say that? You should say that, yes, you're going to Jahannam. Is this the language of Husayn? Are we understanding how you think and work this day and age? How many of the scholars are on social media? How many are seeing the trends that are happening? How many are able to see how a youth wants to maneuver and work in society? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all and grant us a tawfiq to speak the language of the revolutionary grandson of the Holy Prophet. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلي اللهم على محمد وآله الطاهرين.